minus 1, it becomes x minus 1 times x squared plus x plus 1. It's a difference of 2 cubed. This one, remember, we can't factor. Okay, so we leave it like that. When I decompose, I have two fractions. One of x minus 1 and the other one, x squared plus x plus 1. So what do I have on top for each one? This one,
A,
and this one, plus C. Okay, let's find the common denominator. So we have 1 over x minus 1 times x squared plus x plus 1. We multiply a by that, so we have ax squared plus ax plus a. If I multiply bx plus c by x minus 1, I'll have bx squared minus bx plus cx minus c. Okay? Now, we can group them by power of x. So the left side is this one. The coefficient of x squared would be a plus b. The coefficient of x would be
a minus b.
B plus C, okay. And then the constant will turn to be
A minus C.
Great. So we have A plus B equals 0, A minus B plus C equals 0, and A minus C equals 1. So the matrix is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1 minus 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, minus 1, 1.
Sound like a computer.
Yeah.
So binary.
C is negative 2/3.
So not negative.
Negative to negative 2/3.
Negative 2/3.
Yep.
1 minus a. Yeah, that's right. No. What is 1 minus 1/3? Alright, so now let's go back to the decomposition and put those values. So the fraction 1 over x cubed minus 1 is equal to 1/3 over x minus 1. And then both of them are negative, so I can put a minus here. 1/3 x plus 2/3 divided by x squared plus x. And again, I'm going to separate these two. Okay.
Did we already drop the integral?
I'm not doing the integration yet.
Okay, I was
just
curious.
Doing the partial fraction.
I was trying to figure out if I am I writing it down right.
Yeah. I'll just do this because it's a long one. 1/3, then minus 1/3 x over x squared plus x plus 1, then minus 2/3 over x squared plus x. So this one, we know already the answer when I integrate. That's the natural log of x minus 1. This one, I can do a u substitution, as you can see, because the derivative would be 2x plus plus 1, which I don't see. So I have to compute the square of the bottom and then do a u sub, integrate. This one, you have a top, a constant, and the bottom is the quadratic that we can factor. So we need to compute the square, and it's going to become either a tangent inverse or the tangent hyperbolic inverse. So this is the one that is the problem right here, that one. We need to compute the square no matter what because that's the only way we can do it. So let's compute the square of x squared plus x plus 1. I think we did it earlier. It was, suppose I had minus 1/3 x over x squared plus x plus 1 over 4 minus 1 over 4 plus 1. And this becomes? Plus 1/2 squared plus 3/4. Okay. So you see the last one, when you compute the square, you have a 2/3. Okay? And this becomes a tangent inverse. Just exactly the one that we did earlier. 1/√2/√3, tangent inverse of x plus 1/2 times 2/√3. That would be the last one when you integrate. But But this one has an x on top. So what we do u sub, let u be x plus 1 half. So du would be dx, if I integrate this. But then I have to replace this x. So x is what? U minus 1 half, plus x. So now I replace, I'll have, we'll put the minus 1 right here. U minus 1 half over u squared plus 3 over 4 d. Okay? Now, if I separate these two, I have u over u squared plus 3 over 4 du minus 1 half 1 over u squared plus 3 over 4 du. And you can integrate both. This is exactly your u sub. Derivative is 2u, but I don't have a 2. I can divide that one. And it's exactly the tangent inverse, as you can see. So now, if I take the t substitution, let t be t squared plus 3 over 4. So du would be, dt squared would be 2u du. I'll have a 2. This is minus 1 third times 1 half natural log of u squared plus 3 over 4. That's the first one. This one is negative 1 half, 2 over square root of 3, tangent inverse of 2u over square root of 3. And that's just for that one right here. And then we have to replace the 2 by x plus 1 half. So this would be minus 1 over 6 natural log of x plus 1 half square plus 3 over 4 minus 1 over the 2 cancel, so minus 1 over 3 square root of 3 tangent inverse of 2 times x plus 1 half over square root of 3 the same. This is the second interval, the middle one. So that second one, if I didn't have the x, you know, I'm done. But if I have an x, you have to do the u sub. Okay. And then separate again, because this is going to be a linear function. That's the middle one. The first one would be, when I integrate, this just becomes 1 third natural log of x minus 1. Then you add that second one. And the third one would be negative 2 thirds times 2 over square root of 3 tangent inverse of x plus 2 times x plus 1 half over square root of 3. Let's see. This one is this one. This one is that one. And the second one is